Think you know exactly why you don't like someone? While your reasoning might be sound, chances are there's plenty more to it, and it's all backed by science. When watching this video, be prepared to do a whole lot of face-palming. Many of the underlying reasons we have for liking or disliking someone reveal precisely how good we humans are at duping ourselves into reverting back to our primal ways. Our first case in point? Outgroup bias. As practical psychology describes, we see outgroup biases every time people are attracted to other humans who are familiar and not attracted to those who are unfamiliar. For a lighthearted example, think of what it's like for a lone Dallas Cowboys fan to walk into a packed bar full of Eagles fans in Philadelphia right before a divisional playoff game. Or, better yet, imagine showing up at a Star Trek convention dressed as your favorite Star Wars character. Outgroup bias is probably humanity's oldest and most blatantly tribal tendency, one meant to keep us safe from physical harm in the natural world, but which botches modern civil discourse. We see it everywhere we look now, and it often gets quite a bit more ugly than the previously mentioned examples. Next up, we have psychological projection, which is a powerful defense mechanism and unconscious impulse first defined in psychological terms by Sigmund Freud. Put simply, projection is a way of blaming someone else for one's own faults and foibles, rather than taking care of them in oneself, according to Psychology Today. For instance, think back to childhood and recall a bully who used to torment you. Or just imagine one if you were too cool to be bullied. Let's say that the person in question used to make fun of you for allegedly wetting the bed. Chances are, this person had quite a bedwetting problem too and was immensely ashamed by it. Perhaps they had an abusive parent who made it even worse. So instead of dealing with it in a healthy way and conquering the problem, they just chose to take their frustrations out on you. As adults, we all tend to project a little once in a while. Life is difficult, no matter who you are, and it's easy to fall into negative thought patterns that trick you into indulging in this toxic impulse. That's when a good, honest friend comes in handy. Sometimes you need a worthy observer to tell you that you're being a jerk. There's another no-brainer reason you might dislike someone. You might be wrong.
What did you say?
That's a shocking and blasphemous statement, we know. But let's be honest, people are often terrible at understanding other people's feelings, the causes for their actions, and the intentions behind their words and choices. Moreover, people aren't just bad at figuring out what they're not told explicitly. They often disregard what they are told explicitly and even claim that it's not true in order to avoid feeling uncomfortable for being wrong. And out of all the reasons why someone might be reading someone else incorrectly, attribution bias stands head and shoulders above the rest. According to Be Applied, attribution bias involves attributing incorrect causes to someone's actions. Let's say you're standing in line at the store, and someone cuts through the line to get to the door faster. You and others might conclude, based on that one action, that the person is a jerk and doesn't care about respecting other people's personal space simply because they're in a hurry. Or let's say you meet someone for the first time, and they appear distant or uninvolved, which causes you to assume that they have no interest in making new friends. Those judgments, however, may be way off base. Maybe the first person had a medical condition and they were late for an important appointment. Maybe the second person's dog died yesterday and they just don't have the emotional capacity to wholeheartedly engage in conversation with a new person. Situational reasons may be to blame, not someone's innate character. So, you know how a baby smiles if you smile first? That's called mirroring, according to Psych Central, and it's one of the most fundamental ways that social animals like humans develop the core traits necessary for existing in society. It's also, in the midst of the parent-child bond, critical to personality development. Was one's early life caregiver present or absent? Did one's caregiver give willingly or unwillingly? Were resources like food and affection available or withheld? The answers to such questions define adults' relationships, behavioral patterns, and formulate feelings of wariness, affability, the need for comfort, and so forth. This line of inquiry is referred to as attachment theory. If someone's early childhood development was less than ideal, then that person might misread others as an adult. They might conclude that they don't like persons X, Y, or Z because those people represent some facet of an unhealthy early childhood attachment style, or even a traumatic event. Further to the point, adults mirror others just like smiling babies. It might be the case that if someone comes across as unlikable and isn't smiling, engaged, or pleasant, that person could be giving back to you what you're putting out. In the exact same way, people who come across as likable may appear as such because they're mirroring your geniality and openness.
Who sent you?
Papa Elf.
Papa Elf?
Mm-hmm. From the North Pole.
From the North Pole?
Yeah.
Since we're nearing the end of this video, it's important to note that this list is by no means exhaustive. The dynamics of liking or disliking other humans are endlessly complicated, and we're not here to provide you with all of the answers. That being said, let's touch on one other major reason why people might dislike others. Nonverbal communication. People are always emoting, even if they don't realize it. Crossing one's arms, tilting the head, maintaining eye contact, standing near or far away from someone else, as Forbes outlines. These are all examples of communicating how we're really feeling on the inside without using words. In the end, such gestures create in others an overall impression of comfort or discomfort, regardless of conversation or any actual information about a person. Some individuals, like those who are used to public speaking, are great at recognizing and controlling these gestures, which remain largely unconscious. Other people are completely unaware of how they come off to the people they're engaging with. But thankfully, those who aren't so adept can learn. And like the other items on this list, awareness is the first step to taking care of oneself and one's relationships.